Today, some Adobe Illustrator headaches and their remedies, courtesy of Dr. Satori. Stay tuned until the very end, where I have an absolute lifesaver for you to use, in the form of a free plugin. So the first problem that might cause you some huge problems is the align to pixel grid function. Now in CC, that's situated here. But in older versions of Adobe Illustrator, I think it's under the fly down menu in the transform window, and that's located in the top right corner. You're going to need to uncheck the setting called align to pixel grid, but in CC you just click this button here. But anyway, how is this seemingly benign setting a headache? Well, let's activate it and see. When I go to move an angle point around like so, I cannot place it where I want, because Illustrator keeps snapping it to specific locations, and I can't even place it in line with my design. Now if you're not aware of this setting, you can go literally insane trying to figure it out. The next headache that you might encounter randomly in your graphic design workflow comes from a setting hidden in the preference menu. Now if you're having some issues with screen renders, you might want to turn off this setting here to see if that fixes things, because the GPU performance setting can create all kinds of problems. So as you can see on screen now, designers have encountered some weird and annoying problems simply because this setting was activated during their workflow. The GPU setting is meant to boost performance, but it can also cause some issues on specific machines. The third headache that you can encounter is dealing with hex color codes. Now a client might actually require that their design uses a hex color code, and you can find the hex color codes in the color palette here. Now the problem with this is that a hex color code is strictly related to RGB color designs and documents. So take a look at the color code here, it ends in CC. But once I actually add it to my design and then duplicate the object, then go back and check, it's actually been changed to a different color code. This is because I'm on a CMYK document. The way around this is to simply explain to your client that you need a spot color or a CMYK color for your print project, and not a hex color code. Now I've actually encountered this myself a couple of times in the past, and a client would understand if you explain it to them properly. So the fourth headache before I reveal to you guys the awesome plugin that is going to save you some frustrating times is related to a command on your keyboard. So here I'm trying to select my design and see the path and the anchor points, but whatever I do, I can't seem to do that. Now the issue here is that I've accidentally clicked Command H by mistake on my keyboard, and all I need to do is simply repeat this command to revert things back to the default view. So the last headache today is when you forget to save your work and then Illustrator crashes on you. But there's no need to worry anymore, because there's a free Autosave plugin that you can actually download, and I've linked it down in the description box below. So head over to that website and grab it for yourself, totally for free. Remember, if you want to keep boosting your skills and your awareness as a graphic designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. Also, like and share my content on social media, and remember to have a great day everybody. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.